In a press release, it's been noted that the CFPB has determined that it will consider supervising such things as debt collection, consumer reporting, consumer credit and related activities, money transmitting, check cashing, and related services. Is this list now complete?
So, Congressman, I appreciate your asking about this. As you recall, the way Dodd-Frank was set up is that in the non-bank financial institution space, we will automatically be required to supervise three types of institutions, no matter their size: private student lending, payday lending, and mortgages. For the rest of consumer financial services that are not handled by banks, we are required as an agency to supervise the largest, I think it's called large, the large institutions. We are required, again by Dodd-Frank, to set up a rule to determine what that is and what areas it goes into. What we have started doing is, we're not in the formal rulemaking process yet, we're bringing in people.
When will that be?
The formal rulemaking process. I'm sorry, first we got to get better information before we're ready to do a formal rule. So we've started the process by bringing in industry participants, community banks, credit unions, large financial institutions, trade associations, consumer
any
groups.
Any specific criteria that you use in determining these other than largeness and?
Well, this is the interesting question, given the open texture of Dodd-Frank on this point. We've actually been talking with all of the stakeholders about what is the right approach here, and we've gotten some very creative ideas. We're trying to work with them. We're trying to work with industry to find the right way to do this out of the box.
Well, the statement of the openness of Dodd-Frank doesn't give me a lot of comfort about the, not simply the consumer protection, but the protection of liberty.
Fair enough, sir.
Choice, individual freedom, and self-determination as well. So I guess that's why I asked the criteria, but you indicated that it's fairly broad.
I want to say that as best I can. We have gotten enormous support from the industry, from consumer groups, from banking groups, for the process we are using to try to embrace everyone's participation in this and to give them all an opportunity to help us hammer out a rule that works best for everyone. That's what we're working on right now, sir.
I appreciate that. Let me continue that. How will the Bureau undertake the analysis required under Dodd-Frank, such as the impact that a rule or regulation will have on consumers, and what legal protection may already be in place for consumers before the Bureau can promulgate a rule or regulation?
Well, I think the best way to say this is we are building a strong research function. It is our view that it is our responsibility to study and understand how markets are working, what consumers actually face, what community banks actually face in terms of their regulatory hurdles, how markets operate. We will be a data-driven agency. I think we proved that starting back in February, before we were even formally launched, when we started a process to do an analysis of the CARD Act that had passed Congress. And we brought in stakeholders from across the industry. We developed data. We asked for their data so that we could evaluate.
That's broad. But let me ask, just in the remaining 43 seconds I have, how much weight on another area, how much weight will be given to the fact that many products and services that the Bureau could potentially regulate are already well regulated by the states? Bringing the states into the whole equation here.
It is certainly a part of our consideration how much regulation already exists. And if there are no problems, then there are no risks.
How much weight does that play, though, in making that determination?
Big. I mean, it's important. It's heavy. It's very relevant how much regulation, how effective the regulation is, how well enforced the regulation is, how consistent the regulation is throughout the country. Those are enormously important to us as we go forward. And I should say, in our early meetings with the industry, with consumer groups, this is exactly an issue that's been raised, and there were some differences of opinion between, for example, the community banks and the non-regulated financial services industry about how much effective regulation was occurring at the state.
Oh, I appreciate that. I know my time has ended. I would just encourage you to put heavy weight on the states, being that the original intention was not for the federal, but for the states to have that type of control. So, thank you.
I understand it.
I thank the gentleman.